Do you want to advance your ECU development and profit from shift left testing? Creating a level 1 virtual ECU with vVIRTUALtarget may be your first step to improve the development of the application software. Hi, my name is Tanja and I am the product manager for vVIRTUALtarget. I will show you today how you can create a level 1 virtual ECU with vVIRTUALtarget Pro. First, we need an input for the BSW emulation use case. You already have a design for a set of software components in a tool like DaVinci Developer? Great, just export the system description in the ARXML format. Let's go straight to vVIRTUALtarget and create a new project. Add the system descriptions of the software components. Note that the BSW emulation use case is already pre-selected for you. You can import ARXML files of the following types: system descriptions, extract of system descriptions, system extract of system descriptions, software components only, and software component descriptions. Typically, you can export these files from your software component design tool, like DaVinci Developer or Prevision. Does your ARXML file already contain an ECU instance? If it does, vVIRTUALtarget will automatically assign the software components to that ECU. We call this a system-defined ECU, and it won't be possible to add or remove single software components. If not, does the ARXML contain a system which references a root software composition? Then a user-defined ECU will be created automatically, which preserves the connectors between the software components. If not, you have the option to create a user-defined ECU manually within the GUI and assign the single software components. The created virtual ECU does not consider connections within the composition. Now that you built the base, proceed with configuring your virtual ECU. In this sample, the system description does not contain any COM-M or ECU-M service ports. Therefore, choose the setting to run the virtual ECU endlessly. That's all you need to configure for your level 1 virtual ECU, and you can already build the system under test. Switch to the Build tab and select the desired compiler and its configuration, and let vVIRTUALtarget generate your build environment. During the build process, vVIRTUALtarget generates templates for the software components if no application files were added. You can start to develop the application code and later on reuse it for the real target without any adaptations. Using the RTE calls will call the emulated basic software modules in the AUTOSAR runtime library. Running the build process in your generated build environment results in the virtual ECU that you can now use in the simulation environment. So, let's integrate your virtual ECU in CANoe by adding the generated VTTSAT to the CANoe communication setup. It will automatically load the DLL for the system under test and the interface for the communication between CANoe and the virtual ECU. The system under test uses an abstract level for communication. It's not yet based on virtual automotive buses. The abstract communication is realized via so-called distributed objects, which I will refer to as DOs for brevity. DOs are a service-oriented application layer abstraction in CANoe. You can get a good overview of the DOs for the level 1 virtual ECU in CANoe's Symbol Explorer. Each virtual ECU is represented by one DO, and every open or monitored port is represented by a single DO member. Let us compare the DOs in the Symbol Explorer with the initial software design. See that different types of port interfaces are supported. In this example, there are sender-receiver ports, client-server ports, and parameter ports. In the current design, most of the ports are open, meaning that they do not yet have a connection to a different software component or a different ECU. You get a representation for this open port in CANoe. For the internal connection between the two software components, there won't be a representation per default. Nevertheless, it is possible to monitor them by using the port monitoring feature. But that is another story. We will focus on CANoe. The DOs of the light control vECU are connected to the panel. You can, for example, set a value to the light sensor, which represents the client server port. The front light of the car is reflected by the sender receiver port, which is called output. You can even adjust the threshold for turning the lights on and off by tuning the values of the parameter port. We want to test the virtual ECU not only interactively, but also with some test scripts. There are quite a lot of tools to help write tests, too many to mention them all in this video. Therefore, I just wrote a little example which shows you how to use CANoe, or better, this script, to act as server for the client server port. This method, light intensity called, is called whenever the light control virtual ECU uses the RTE call function. Okay, let's summarize. You build a level 1 virtual ECU by using vVIRTUALtarget Pro. As input, you just needed an ARXML file describing the software components. You integrated the build system under test into a CANoe simulation and learned how to stimulate and monitor the different open port types. This is just the beginning, but a powerful base to start early with your SIL tests. Thanks for watching. If you have further questions, please consult our knowledge base or contact my support colleagues. This was the BSW emulation use case. But what about the integration use case of vVIRTUALtarget? Watch our other tech tutorial to create a level 3 vECU with an autosar stack. And don't forget to subscribe to the Vector Tech Tutorial channel. Did we forget the bell? We forgot the bell.